Good morning, all of you. So today we will try to discuss the two things. Out of that, the number one is the comparison between electric and the magnetic circuit. So it's my request to all the students, please take a note. Please just make the title in your notebook, the comparison between electric and the magnetic circuit. And now we will try to discuss, or we will try to compare these two circuits, electric circuit and the magnetic circuit, based on the concepts we discussed till now. Okay, so you have to take a note, you have to write it down, this comparison. So this comparison we will do by considering the two things. One is the similarities and that other one is the dissimilarities, means the certain things are similar in between electric and the magnetic circuit, and certain things are dissimilar. So we will take a note of these two things here. Okay, so in the comparison, you just try to make the number here. Here I can write A, similarities, and B we will consider that as a dissimilarities. So number one, so all of you just see the diagram and try to draw the diagram. But I observe that it's quite impossible to draw the diagram of a magnetic circuit. But let me try to draw the simple one diagram for you. So you can try to draw the diagram what I draw for the magnetic circuit. Electric circuit, you can draw it, no problem. Okay, have you completed that, the first part, the circuit diagram of electric and the magnetic circuit? Yes or no? Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the first part is the circuit diagram of this magnetic and the electric circuit. Okay. It's over. Don't draw this diagram. I'm not getting why this time is required. This one is the diagram for magnetic circuit. It will take a lot of time to draw this diagram. Is it over or not? First comparison.
ओवर सर।
ओके, द सेकंड वन इज द डेफिनेशन, सो राइट डाउन द डेफिनेशन फॉर द इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट। द डेफिनेशन इज द क्लोज्ड पाथ फॉलोड बाय इलेक्ट्रिक करंट इज कॉल्ड इलेक्ट्रिक सर्किट। सिमिलरली वी कैन डिफाइन दैट द मैग्नेटिक सर्किट विद द सेम वे, जस्ट that electric current is replaced by the magnetic flux. So the definition for the magnetic circuit is the closed path followed by magnetic flux is called a magnetic circuit. Or
over, sir.
The number three. The movable part in that electric circuit is the electric current, and this electric current we can write, which is equal to EMF upon resistance. Out of that, the denominator part, resistance, is the opposition to the flow of current. So you can write that equation for current, which is equal to EMF upon resistance. In the same way, the moving or the movable part in the magnetic circuit is the flux. It can be denoted by phi, which is equal to MMF upon reluctance. So the similarity is that in that electric circuit, that electromotive force is there. In the magnetic circuit, magnetomotive force is there. In that electric circuit, opposing part to the flow of current is a resistance. In the magnetic circuit, the opposing part to the flux is a reluctance. It can be denoted by S. So these are the similarities. Okay, so let me go to that the next slide. Okay, then write down. In that electric circuit, voltage drops across any part of the circuit, we can calculate by using the formula I into R, current into resistance. It's a voltage drop. Similarly, in the magnetic circuit, MMF across any part of that magnetic circuit, we can calculate by using. Now, how you can remember? As you know that I is analogous to phi. So I is replaced by phi. And the R is analogous to the reluctance. So that R is replaced by reluctance. So these are the similarities. Then fifth similarities, as you know that the resistance is the opposing part to the current, but the conductance, which is nothing but the, it gives the permission to the flow of a current in the wire or that in the conductor, so that the conductance, which is nothing but the reciprocal of a resistance. Resistance is the opposing part, but the conductance is the permission part. And its a unit is a siemen. Or another one unit for the conductance is MHO. Baga? SI unit for the conductance is a siemen, it's right. But as the conductance is the reciprocal of a resistance, so that unit is, see that the symbol, the resistance symbol is what? And the mo. Actually, if you try to spell backward, OHM, ohm cha reverse, because it is the reciprocal, because what is the resistance, unit of the resistance? It's a ohm, but the conductance is the reciprocal of a resistance, so that it's a unit is a mo, and it can be that exactly opposite of the symbol of that ohm, because it is the permission to the flow of a current. So this concept, we call it a conductance. Similarly, in the magnetic circuit, the reluctance is the opposition to the flow of flux, and the permeance is the permission to the flow of flux to the material, so that the reciprocal of reluctance, we call it a permeance, and its unit is exactly reverse to the reluctance, which is nothing but Weber per ampere turn. Hey Sudhan, lihun gya tumhi. The conductance unit, it's a mo or siemen. Maybe that MCQ type of question it may ask on that part. And the last one similarities is current density. आता हा पार्ट काय आपण बघितलं नाही, मे बी तुम्ही 11वी मध्ये किंवा 12वी मध्ये तो बघितला असू शकतो. द करंट डेन्सिटी इज इक्वल टू करंट डिवाइडेड बाय एरिया, युनिट इज एम्पियर पर मीटर स्क्वेअर. सिमिलर कन्सेप्ट इन द मॅग्नेटिक सर्किट. आता हा पार्ट आपण इथं बघितलेला आहे. फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी विच इज इक्वल टू फ्लक्स पर युनिट एरिया, विच इज नथिंग बट द युनिट इज वेपर पर मीटर स्क्वेअर, ऑर इट्स अ टेस्ला. Is it over?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And now, dissimilarities. Now your title, B title. Dissimilarities between electric and द मॅग्नेटिक सर्किट. आतापर्यंत आपण सिमिलरिटीज बघितल्या, आता डिसिमिलरिटीज बघतोय आपण. ओके, सो द फर्स्ट, electric circuit can be open and in terms of magnetic circuit, the magnetic circuit is always closed. This is the dissimilarities. Second one, dissimilarities, I will dictate it. I have not written here, but I will dictate it, but you can try to write it down. Once that first dissimilarity is over, give me the message so that I can dictate the second dissimilarities. Is it over? First dissimilarities. Now second dissimilarities, write down. In electric circuit, actual current flows. And now in terms of magnetic circuit, write down. In magnetic circuit, a magnetic flux is the imaginary concept. Magnetic flux is the imaginary concept. This is the second dissimilarity. In the magnetic circuit, the magnetic flux is the imaginary concept. And now, third one, dissimilarities. Now you can write it down. Electric energy is continuously required. Electric energy is continuously required to produce and maintain current in the circuit. To produce and maintain current in the circuit. And second thing, in the magnetic circuit, the magnetic energy is only required to set up flux. Magnetic energy is only required to set up flux. म्हणजे फक्त flux produce करण्यासाठी magnetic energy लागते. The magnetic energy is not required to maintain the magnetic flux. This is the dissimilarities there. And then number four, conductivity and the resistivity. Conductivity and the resistivity remains constant at constant temperature. Conductivity and resistivity remains constant at constant temperature. At constant temperature. And in the magnetic circuit, write down permeability and reflectivity do not remain constant at constant temperature. Do not remain constant at constant temperature. Is it all? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And now, just concentrate here. Once again, I will try to clear that the concepts in terms of magnetic, and don't write it down this title. I want to clear that the few more concepts. Baga, here I can write electric circuit. And here I can write magnetic circuit. Okay. Now, number one, the force required to flow that electric current in that electric circuit, we call as a electromotive force. In terms of magnetic circuit, it's a magnetomotive force. Is it right? Then second, in that electric circuit, a current, it actually flows, but in the magnetic circuit, magnetic flux phi is the imaginary concept. Third, in that electric circuit, opposition to the flow of electric current that we call as a resistance. And in the magnetic circuit, opposition to the flow of a flux that we call as a reluctance. Yes. In that electric circuit, the formula for resistance R, which is equal to rho L by A. In the magnetic circuit, the formula for the reluctance S is L divided by mu zero
mu r a. Okay. In that electric circuit, the reciprocal of resistance, we call it a conductance. It can be denoted by the letter G, and its unit is mho or Siemens. Is it right? And now, in terms of the magnetic circuit, the reciprocal of reluctance, what we called? What is that term? Right now, I just discussed. I forgot that name.
Permeance.
It's a permeance, correct? It's a permeance, which is equal to 1 upon S, and its unit is ampere turn per Weber. Okay. So these are the points, these are the major points you have to compare or you have to understand in between that electric and that magnetic circuit.
Sir, unit unit Weber per ampere by jana.
Exactly reverse. It's a Weber per ampere turn. Okay. Now, in that electric circuit, conductivity. Now, this is the conductance. But in the, I say that in that electric circuit, now we discuss that one more term, conductivity, which is nothing but the reciprocal of resistivity, rho. Resistivity means what? Actually, the resistivity is nothing but the resistance. But the conductivity means what? It is the reciprocal of resistivity. It means that it's a permission. Is it right? Similarly, in the magnetic circuit, it is called as a reluctivity, actually, or permeability, I say that. The permeability means what? It's a mu, is it right? But the reluctivity, which is nothing but the reciprocal of the permeability, is that. Are you clear my point? So this is the new point, I think, in the previous. Here, if you try to observe that, the conductivity, new word it comes, and one is the reluctivity, another one new word comes. The permeability, you know that, and the resistivity, you know that. Is it that? Permeability is nothing but mu, and the resistivity is nothing but the rho. But the reciprocal of resistivity, we call it a conductivity, and the reciprocal of permeability, we call it a reluctivity. That's why I have tried to show it here. So please have a note of this 6-1 point in you can note it down somewhere. So suppose, actually this is not a part of a syllabus, but suppose that question, it comes for MCQ type of question, that times you must know that what is mean by that reluctivity and the conductivity. Actually, this conductance, this permeance, this reluctivity and the conductivity, it's not a part of that syllabus. But you please take, note it down as an additional part. Okay. Have you noted? Yes or no? Not necessary to write all these things. All these things are with you. Only the last one point is not with you. Then give me that message once your part is over. Okay. Now, let me erase these things here. And now, all of you, just make the title magnetic leakage and fringing. Magnetic leakage and fringing. And then just concentrate here. Have you made the title? Have you prepared the title? Shall I start?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, please concentrate. It's a very, very important concepts in a theory part. And based on that, again, we have to try to solve the numerical. But before that, try to understand the concept very well. If you read the title, magnetic leakage and fringing, actually, the title is nothing but the two concepts are there. The first concept is a leakage.
Yes, sir.
What? Okay, the first concept is a leakage and the second concept is the fringing. Is it right? But both these concepts are happen simultaneously in the magnetic circuit. Actually, these are the two different concepts. Magnetic leakage is the first one concept and the magnetic fringing is the second one concept. But what I say that these two concepts are happened in the magnetic circuit simultaneously so that our title is magnetic leakage and fringing. Now we will try to discuss the concepts separately. First, we will try to discuss that what is mean by that magnetic leakage. Then we will discuss that what is mean by that magnetic fringing. And then I will show you, then I will discuss with you how these two concepts are happened simultaneously in the magnetic circuit. So be ready to listen the things related to these two concepts. So the first concept is the magnetic leakage. And for that, here I have considered that one iron ring or magnetic, any magnetic material ring. If you see that this ring having an area of cross section of a meter square, the mean length of this iron ring is of L meter. And now we consider that a one wire is entirely wound on that iron ring here. In the diagram, it is shown that only the some part of that ring is wound with the coil. But actually, the entire ring is wound with the coil. Now you can try to imagine the diagram. If the entire ring is wound with a coil, n number of turns, with a n number of turns. So may I say that this complete circuit, it acts like a solenoid coil. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you are agree with my statement, this entire coil, when it is wound with this ring, then this will be acts as a solenoid coil. What is the important thing about the magnetic field in terms of solenoid coil? Will you please give me that? Will you remember these things? What is that important thing? So many times we discuss the things till now. Now I want these important things from your side. What is that important thing in terms of solenoid coil? That's why I say that I discussed so many times, I cannot count in a number also. And if I discuss that so many times and now if you can't give me that important thing, then it's a quite difficult thing is that. What is that important?
outside the coil is negligible.
Absolutely correct. The very important thing in terms of solenoid coil is the magnetic field due to solenoid inside the solenoid is very strong, and outside the solenoid it's a very negligible, or practically we say that it's a zero. Is it right? मग आता ही ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही रिंग कन्सिडर करताय आणि त्या रिंग भोवती वायर वाउंड केले एन नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स, मग मला सांगा त्याचा एक्सपेक्टेड मॅग्नेटिक लाईनचा किंवा मॅग्नेटिक फील्डचा एक्सपेक्टेड पाथ कोणता असणार आहे? इनसाइड द रिंग, बरोबर आहे. आउटसाइड काय असणार आहे का? वी कन्सिडर दॅट आउटसाइड इज अ व्हेरी निग्लिजिबल, अँड द निग्लिजिबल इट स्टँड्स फॉर definitely practically the certain flux will take a path outside the ring is there. It means that actually that expected when the current is flowing through the coil, expected path of the magnetic flux produced by the current, who will produce that magnetic flux? Ata mala sanga jar ya coil madun jar current flow zala nahi tar magnetic flux tayar hoo shakto ka? Who is responsible to produce the magnetic flux? If I become zero, is the flux will produce? Absolutely no. It means that I is the responsible for production of a magnetic flux. Means when I consider that a current is flowing through the coil, this is the expected path of a magnetic flux. Why I say that inside that iron ring is the expected path? Because practically we consider that outside that solenoid coil the magnetic field is negligible. It means that as we know that when the current will flow through the coil, the magnetic field is produced, and this magnetic field inside the solenoid coil is strong. So can I make a one sentence here? The magnetic field produced by the current flowing through the coil is the total magnetic field, but out of that total magnetic field, the large part of a magnetic field will take a path inside the solenoid coil, and the small part of the magnetic field will take a path outside the solenoid coil. Do you agree with me? Yes or no? Or may I repeat the things, these things? Once again, I will repeat. Consider this ring having a certain dimension. Now, when this ring is wound, and this ring is entirely wound with a coil, it will act as a solenoid. And when it will act as a solenoid, experimentally, it is found that the magnetic field inside the solenoid. आता त्या कॉइलच्या इनसाइड काय आहे? ती रिंग आहे, कारण कॉइल ही त्या रिंग वरती वाउंड केलेली आहे. म्हणजे कॉइलच्या इनसाइड जे असणार आहे ती असणार आहे आयर्न रिंग. आता आपण याला आयर्न रिंग म्हणूया. ही काय आहे? आयर्न रिंग, बरोबर आहे. ही काय आहे? कॉइल, किंवा त्याला एक्साइटिंग कॉइल सुद्धा म्हणतात. एक्साइटिंग कॉइल का म्हणतात? कारण ही कॉइल आहे म्हणून तर मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड तयार होते. ही कॉइलच नसती तर मॅग्नेटिक फील्ड तयार झाली असती का? बरोबर. हा काय आहे? त्या कॉइल मधून फ्लो होणारा करंट, याला सुद्धा म्हणतात एक्साइटिंग करंट. मला वाटतं तुम्ही न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व करताना तो शब्द बघितलेला आहे, बघा, दॅट एक्साइटिंग करंट. डू यू रिमेंबर? येस ऑर नो?
येस सर.
ओके, नाव अज्युम दॅट this coil is entirely wound on that ring, then it acts as a solenoid coil, and we know that when the current is flowing through the coil, magnetic field is produced. It means that the current is responsible to produce the magnetic flux. If current becomes zero, no magnetic field is produced. Is it right? Means the current is the essential part to produce the magnetic field. And when current is flowing through this coil, when the current is circulated through the coil, the magnetic field is produced, and the expected path of a magnetic field is inside the solenoid coil, it means that inside that iron ring is the expected path. So this is the expected path of a magnetic field. But practically, definitely whatever the magnetic field is produced by this current flowing through the coil, the large part of that field will take the expected path. It means that inside the ring, but the small part of the magnetic field will take the path outside the magnetic field or outside the solenoid coil is there. It means that in this way, this is the expected path of a magnetic flux, and the some part of that magnetic field, it will take the path outside the solenoid coil is there. Do you imagine these things? Yes or no? And the flux which will not take the desired path, expected path of a magnetic field, it means that this one is called as a leakage flux. Why we call it a leakage flux? Because this flux will not take the expected path of a magnetic field. It will take the path outside the solenoid coil. That's why the flux which will take or which will not take the desired path of a magnetic field, that flux we call it's a leakage flux is there. Remember that concept? Understand that concept? And practically, definitely, the leakage flux is always present, but that flux is in very small amount. Because the large part of the flux produced by the current will take the path of a desired path, expected path, inside the solenoid coil is there. And the small part of the flux will take the path of a outside through the surrounding medium. It will complete, it's a closed path. So the flux which will not take the desired path of a magnetic circuit, that flux we call it a leakage flux is there. Try to read it. The definition for the magnetic leakage. The flux that does not follow the desired path in a magnetic circuit is called the leakage flux. Is it that clear? Yes or no? Now see that, as we already say that, a current flowing through the coil, which is responsible to produce the flux, to produce the flux. So the current produces the magnetic field or the total flux, that is we call it's a total flux. The current flowing through the coil, we call it's a, or the current produces the flux, that we call it's a total flux. Out of that, the large part of a flux will take a path through the expected magnetic circuit. It's right. So we call it is the useful flux. The flux which will take the desired path, that flux we call it a useful flux. And the flux which will not take the desired path, that flux we call it a leakage flux. So according to that concept, can I write this mathematical equation? So total flux is the flux produced by the current. Out of that, the total flux, the large part of the flux will take the desired path. It means that inside the solenoid coil, and the a very little part will take the path through the surrounding medium, that we call it a leakage flux. So can I write this equation? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So please try to remember. So to which flux we call it a useful flux? The flux which will take the desired path, that flux we call it a useful flux. And the flux which will not take the desired path, that flux we call it a leakage flux. And the total flux is the addition of a useful flux plus a leakage flux is there. Is it that clear? Now, see that. The most of the practical magnetic circuit, in most of the practical magnetic circuit, the large part of a flux is through the magnetic material. It means that inside the solenoid coil, inside that iron ring material, and a very small part of a flux is through the surrounding medium. So this is the concept of the magnetic leakage. Atta paryanta apan jeves numerical solve kele simple magnetic circuit varti, tya thikani apan magnetic leakage ni neglect karat hoto. Tya thikani apan magnetic leakage ni निग्लेक्ट करत होतो त्यावेळेस तुम्हाला एका न्यूमेरिकल मध्ये एक शब्द आलेला दिसेल. आठवेल बघा, निग्लेक्ट द मॅग्नेटिक लिकेज अँड फ्रिंजिंग. आठवतोय का? निग्लेक्ट करतोय. आता ज्यावेळेस मी मॅग्नेटिक लिकेज निग्लेक्ट करतोय, आता मी आता एक फॉर्म्युला लिहिला होता. कोणता फॉर्म्युला लिहिला होता? टोटल फ्लक्स विच इज इक्वल टू युजफुल फ्लक्स प्लस लिकेज फ्लक्स. मग आता ज्यावेळेस आपण लिकेज फ्लक्स हा निग्लेक्ट करतोय, म्हणजे लिकेज फ्लक्स झिरो आहे असं जर अज्युम केलं, तर त्याचा अर्थ काय होतोय? कोण सांगू शकतोय का बघा मला? ज्यावेळेस मी लिकेज फ्लक्स हा झिरो आहे असा कन्सिडर करतोय, याचा अर्थ काय होतो?
टोटल फ्लक्स इज इक्वल टू युजेबल.
ऍब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. मॅथमॅटिकली यू कॅन से दॅट टोटल फ्लक्स इज इक्वल टू युजफुल फ्लक्स. मीन्स व्हॉट? आता हे एक्सप्लेन करता यायला पाहिजे तुम्हाला. याचा अर्थ असा होतो की या करंटमुळे जेवढा फ्लक्स तयार झालेला आहे तो सगळ्याच्या सगळा फ्लक्स हा डिझायर्ड पाथ घेतोय, म्हणजे इनसाइड द सोलेनॉइड कॉइल आहे. आउटसाइड द सोलेनॉइड कॉइल इट्स अ झिरो. बरोबर आहे? म्हणजे आतापर्यंत आपण न्युमेरिकल सॉल्व्ह करत असताना लिकेज फ्लक्स हा झिरो कन्सिडर केलाय, झिरो अज्युम केलाय, म्हणजे सगळ्याच्या सगळा फ्लक्स जेवढा फ्लक्स करंट न तयार केलेला आहे तेवढा सगळा फ्लक्स हा आपण इनसाइड द सोलेनॉइड कॉइल अज्युम केलाय. परंतु ज्यावेळेस आपण आता लिकेज कन्सिडर करणार त्यावेळेस सगळा फ्लक्स हा इनसाइड द सोलेनॉइड कॉइल असेल का? डेफिनेटली नॉट. कारण आपण ज्यावेळेस लिकेज फ्लक्स कन्सिडर केला याचा अर्थ असा झाला की काहीतरी फ्लक्स हा सराउंडिंग मीडियम मधून लीक झालेला आहे. सराउंडिंग मीडियम मधून तो त्याचा कम्प्लीट पाथ कन्सिडर केलेला आहे. Get it, my point? And now henceforth, whenever we will try to solve the numerical, we will have the attention towards the leakage flux also. If you say that the leakage flux is present, it means that the useful flux is less than the total flux is there. Do you agree with me? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so please try to remember that. What is mean by that? द मॅग्नेटिक लिकेज हा झाला तुमचा पहिला कन्सेप्ट. आता दुसरा कन्सेप्ट असा आहे द मॅग्नेटिक फ्रिंजिंग. आता हा फ्रिंजिंगचा कन्सेप्ट काय आहे? प्लीज ट्राय टू रिमेंबर. वन्स अगेन आय कन्सिडर दॅट अ वन रिंग. सपोज याला तुम्ही अज्युम करा दिस इज नथिंग बट आयर्न रिंग हॅव्हिंग अ सर्टन डायमेन्शन. नाउ दिस रिंग इज एंटायरली वाउंड विथ अ कॉइल एन नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स. इज इट राईट? Now suppose we consider that there is a one socket to that iron ring. One socket means what? Suppose I say that iron ring is cut in this section so that here one air gap is produced. Now this is nothing but that air gap. Do you observe this thing, air gap? Atapurenta complete iron ring consider keli hoti. परंतु आता फ्रिंजिंग कन्सेप्ट लक्षात येण्यासाठी आपण काय अज्युम केलेलं आहे? देर इज अ वन सॉकट टू दॅट आयर्न रिंग. सॉकट मीन्स वेन स्मॉल एअर गॅप इज प्रेझेंट इन दॅट आयर्न रिंग इज देअर. अँड नाउ व्हॉट हॅपन ड्यू टू दॅट स्मॉल एअर गॅप? जस्ट ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड द थिंग हियर. वेन द कॉइल इज एंटायरली वाउंड ऑन दॅट आयर्न रिंग, एज यू नो दॅट दिस विल ऍक्ट एज अ सोलेनॉइड कॉइल. So the desired path of a magnetic flux inside the solenoid coil is this one. This is the desired path. And as you know that the magnetic lines of force always, always take a closed curve path. Mata javeles apan ek socket consider karu, javeles tyatna ek terminal ha N terminal mun act hoil ani dusra terminal ha S terminal mun act. So this is the desired path of a magnetic flux. But as we know that if you consider that the magnetic leakage, it means that a very small part of a total flux will complete the closed path through the surrounding medium. It will not flow through the expected path. It will not take the expected path is there. So this is the expected path of a magnetic flux. This is the leakage flux. Now if you say in that air gap, now just have the focus towards that the air gap. in between the edge of that air gap, this is the edge, this is the first edge and this is the second edge. In between the edge of that air gap, what you observe? What you observe in between the edge of that air gap? So your observation, it should be like that. The magnetic lines of force are traveling in the same direction and parallel to one another. Do you agree with my statement? Yes or no? In the air gap, the magnetic flux lines are flowing in a one direction and parallel to one another. Do you agree with me? Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Hey, why you are not responding me? तुम्हाला काय तिथं दिसतंय बघा एअर गॅप मध्ये आता सध्या ते मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स एकाच डायरेक्शन मध्ये आहेत ते एकमेकाला पॅरल आहेत येस ऑर नो
येस सर
देन व्हॉट इज द बेसिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ दॅट मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स व्हेन द मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स ट्रॅव्हलिंग इन अ वन डायरेक्शन पॅरल टू वन अनदर व्हॉट इज द प्रॉपर्टी अरे तुम्ही काहीतरी अभ्यास करत जावा की रे थोडं तरी वाचन करा की मी तुम्हाला कितीतरी वेळे सांगितलं की ही एक प्रॉपर्टी जी आपण पुढं आपल्याला लागणार आहे हे पण मी तुम्हाला त्याचं सूचित केलं होतं आणि ती प्रॉपर्टी असं नाहीये की तुमच्यासाठी ती नवीन असणार आहे मी कितीतरी वेळेस ती प्रॉपर्टी डिस्कस केलेली आहे आता जर मी ती प्रॉपर्टी सांगितली तर तुम्ही म्हणाल की हो सर माहित आहे
सर
हा
मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स ऑलवेज फॉलोज क्लोज्ड पाथ
येस म्हणून तर ते अशी क्लोज्ड पाथ घेते एन टर्मिनल कडून एस टर्मिनल कडे अजून एक प्रॉपर्टी आहे व्हेन हा येस प्लीज कुलकर्णी हा कुलकर्णी एवढा वेळ का घेत आहे त्यावर When the magnetic lines of force, when they travel in a one direction parallel to one another, they always try to repel to each other. बघितली का नाही प्रॉपर्टी ही बरोबर आहे मग आता मला सांगा या एअर गॅप मध्ये जी मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्सेस आहेत ते पॅरल टू वन अनादर आहेत अँड वेन दे आर पॅरल टू वन अनादर दे ऑलवेज ट्राय टू रिपेल वन अनादर मग आता जर त्या एअर गॅप मध्ये ती मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स ते एकमेकांना कायम रिपेल करत असतील सो कॅन आय से दॅट द डायग्राम शुड बी लाईक दिस इज इट राईट द डायग्राम शुड बी लाईक दिस इट मीन्स दॅट द मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स वेन दे ट्राय टू रिपेल वन अनादर इन द एअर गॅप इट मीन्स दॅट they try to spread out in that air gap they try to bulge out in that air gap so that effective area of cross section in that air gap will be increased and if the effective area of cross section it will be increases in that air gap so this phenomena is called as a magnetic fringing what is meant by that magnetic fringing in the air gap The magnetic lines of force, they try to repel one another so that the magnetic field inside the air gap will be tried to spread out, bulge out, so that effective area of cross-section of that air gap will be increases. This phenomena is called as a magnetic fringing. Lakshyat yate mi kay mantoy te? Concept lakshyat ala ka baga? Yes or no? फक्त एअर गॅप मध्ये कॉन्सन्ट्रेट करा एअर गॅप मध्ये द मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स आर ट्रॅव्हलिंग इन अ वन डायरेक्शन अँड पॅरल टू वन अनदर सो ड्यू टू द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स इन द एअर गॅप द मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स आर स्प्रेड आउट ब्लज आउट अँड ड्यू टू दॅट दॅट एरिया क्रॉस सेक्शन बट जरी ते स्प्रेड आउट झाले एअर गॅप मध्ये तरी देखील ते क्लोज पाथ घेणारच आहे म्हणून तर इथं तुम्हाला डायग्राम दाखवताना मी कशी दाखवलेली आहे अशी दाखवलेली आहे because they try to repel one another, but still they complete their closed path. It means that in the air gap, the area of cross section of this magnetic field will be increases as compared to that steel, that iron ring. That area of cross section for the magnetic field, it will be increases, and this phenomena is called as a magnetic fringing. This is called as a magnetic fringing. Mata, tumhi kasi define karnar magnetic fringing? At the edge of that air gap, the magnetic flux lines are trying to spread out, blurs out. That phenomena is called as a magnetic fringing. It's a type. And as you know that, the flux which is taken that the expected path, and that expected path flux which is available in that air gap, so that flux we call it's a useful flux is there. We call it the useful flux. Now try to read that the definition of a magnetic fringing. Read it very carefully. The parallel lines of force acting in the same direction experience the force of repulsion while crossing the air gap. Due to this property of lines of force, the useful flux in the air gap has a tendency to bulge out. Due to the property of lines of force, comma, the useful flux in that air gap has a tendency to bulge out or spread out at the edge of that air gap, as shown in figure. This effect is known as a fringing effect. Is it that clear? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
मग आता जर मी म्हणलं इफ वी निग्लेक्ट द फ्रिंजिंग, आता याचा कोण अर्थ सांगू शकताय का बघा. इफ वी निग्लेक्ट द फ्रिंजिंग मीन्स एक्झॅक्टली व्हॉट? जर तुम्हाला याचा अर्थ सांगता आला तर मी मला एक्नॉलेजमेंट मिळते की माझा कन्सेप्ट तुमच्यापर्यंत पोहोचला.
म्हणजे तिथं एअर गॅप नसायला पाहिजे आणि मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स एकमेकांपासून दूर जायला नको, ती पॅरलच पाहिजे.
सी दॅट इफ दॅट एअर गॅप इज देअर, डेफिनेटली वी कॅनॉट अवॉइड दॅट. आपण तो एअर गॅप काढून टाकू शकतो का? नाही. मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स हे एकमेकाला तर कायम पॅरलच असणार आहे, ते आपण त्याच्यावरती कंट्रोल करू शकतो का? नाही. मग आपण त्याला फ्रिंजिंग इफेक्ट कसं म्हणू शकतो? जर मी फ्रिंजिंग झिरो केला आयडियल केस मध्ये, बघा आता मला सांगा, ज्यावेळेस फ्रिंजिंग होत आहे एअर गॅप मध्ये, ज्यावेळेस फ्रिंजिंग होत आहे त्यावेळेस मी काय म्हणलेलं आहे, तिथला एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन काय होतोय, इन्क्रीज होतोय का डिक्रीज होतोय?
इन्क्रीज होतो.
आता बघा, हे बघा, ह्या आयर्न रिंगचा एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन हा एवढा होता ज्याच्यातून मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्सेस फ्लो होत होत्या आयर्न रिंग मध्ये. आता ज्यावेळेस फ्रिंजिंग इफेक्ट आहे त्यावेळेस त्याचा एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन हा एवढा झाला, म्हणजे इन्क्रीज झाला का डिक्रीज झाला?
इन्क्रीज झाला.
आता जर एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन इन्क्रीज झाला तर त्याचा इफेक्ट फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी वरती काय होईल?
कमी होईल फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी.
बरोबर, कारण आपल्याकडे फ्लक्स डेन्सिटीचा फॉर्म्युला आहे फाय अपॉन ए. मग एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन इन्क्रीज झाला तर फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी काय होणार आहे? डिक्रीज होणार आहे. म्हणजे एअर गॅप मध्ये फ्लक्स डेन्सिटी ही डिक्रीज होते, हा एक दुसरा कन्सेप्ट सांगितला. आता ज्यावेळेस मी म्हणतोय की मॅग्नेटिक फ्रिंजिंग निग्लेक्ट करा, मॅग्नेटिक फ्रिंजिंग निग्लेक्ट करा, याचा अर्थ असा होतो, लेट मी रिमूव्ह दिस थिंग्स, मॅग्नेटिक फ्रिंजिंग निग्लेक्ट करा याचा अर्थ असा होतो की या एअर गॅप मध्ये मॅग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लाईन्स ह्या स्प्रेड झाल्या नाहीत पाहिजेत. बरोबर आहे? बरोबर आहे का? कारण त्या स्प्रेड झाला तर आपण काय म्हणणार आहे, फ्रिंजिंग इफेक्ट झाला. परंतु त्या स्प्रेड नाही झाल्या म्हणजे काय म्हणणार होतो आपण त्याला, निग्लेक्ट द फ्रिंजिंग. मग जर मॅग्नेटिक लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स ह्या स्प्रेड झाल्या नाही तर मला सांगा या रिंगचा एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन आणि या एअर गॅपचा एरिया ऑफ क्रॉस सेक्शन सेम असेल का डिफरंट असेल?
सेम असेल.
दिस इज नथिंग बट द निग्लेक्ट ऑफ अ मॅग्नेटिक फ्रिंजिंग. दिस इज नथिंग बट द निग्लेक्ट ऑफ अ मॅग्नेटिक फ्रिंजिंग. इफ area of cross section of an air gap and area of cross section of that iron ring, if it is same, it simply indicates that we are neglecting the magnetic fringing. And if we are neglecting the magnetic leakage, it means that when this leakage flux is zero, means whatever the flux is produced by this current, when all the flux will take the path of the expected magnetic circuit, that is nothing but the neglect leakage. Concept lakshat ala? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So please have a focus on it. What is meant by that magnetic leakage and the fringing is there. Okay, so today we stop here, and from the next lecture onwards, definitely we will try to solve the numericals on by considering this concept, the magnetic leakage and the fringing. So it's my request today, you please use your 15 minutes time to understand the concept of a magnetic leakage and the fringing. Is it that clear? So today we stop here. Let me take that as attendance. So many students, it is observed that they join the session very late.